Welcome back to 5 Talk Street. I'm Kris Gutierrez. Every year, the city of the Colony honors our veterans with an exciting event, American Heroes, a Salute to Veterans. And joining me now are Richard Ensweiler, commander of the American Legion Post 21, and the Colony's mayor, Joe McCourry. Thank you both for being here. Mayor, we'll start with you because I know you served our country. Tell our viewers where you served, how you served, and what an event like this means for you happening in your city.
Right. I was in the United States Marine Corps. Mm-hmm. I was an embassy Marine. I spent time protecting our embassy staff and facilities in Ghana, West Africa, and in Bonn, West Germany.
How did that change your life?
Oh, seeing all of the things that happen, especially from a diplomatic side, along with the military side, gave me a great perspective in looking at life today, how much our military needs to be supported across the political spectrum, especially. Sure. And that's what I'm doing in my job today, to make sure that they get the best support they can within our city going forward. And this celebration, the Salute to American Heroes, is our way of doing that.
Just serving in a different capacity nowadays, aren't you?
Absolutely.
I love that it's happening in your city. Tell us, Richard, about this event and why it's so special for so many people.
Well, we have a good-sized veterans community in the Colony. Mm-hmm. And with the mayor being a veteran and with so many people in leadership being veterans, it's just time to make sure that we understand, or the public understands, how much we appreciate them.
Yeah.
And so it's a carnival, it's stage shows, we have big name entertainment, we have a big silent auction to support Kill 22 and warriors, wounded warriors. We just have a lot that focuses on the veteran.
Let's talk a little bit more about it, because I believe on the 7th is when the carnival begins. You mentioned big name entertainers, but you didn't name drop on me. I want to hear some of this, because if you like country music, y'all, you need to be in the Colony.
That's for sure.
Tell us more about what Cory Morrow, Jack Ingram, and then on Saturday, Sundance Head, who was on The Voice.
On The Voice.
Shenandoah, John Michael Montgomery. Y'all, you had me at country music. I am sold. I told you I grew up right down the street there in Louisville. What does it mean for veterans, do you think, Mayor? A day like this where the community can come together, say thank you, and just have fun together.
You know, all of our experiences over the past 12 years of having this, you know, the veterans, they come, they have a great time, they bring their families. Mm-hmm. We also have a big billboard that showcases and shows photos of all of our veterans. They just send in a photo, we put it up on a big screen so that everybody can see them. So their children can see, hey, there was dad back
when
he was 18 years old, right?
Is that new this year, the big LED screen? Because I love the idea. Is that something you guys have done?
We had a smaller screen in past years, but this big LED screen is really going to showcase that this year.
This is Texas. Go big or go home, right?
Right.
You mentioned the silent auction, Richard. Talk to us about, do you know what type of giveaways there are there? What are some of the items?
People from the community donate, and it depends on what they're willing
whatever
to put
comes
forth.
Up.
Yes,
and,
yes. And then I've been a purchaser, but I haven't contributed.
I love it. But where does that money go? You mentioned that there was one organization that will be a
Kill 22. So Kill 22 is an organization that supports mental health for veterans.
Oh.
There are 22 veterans that commit suicide every day in America.
Oh, wow.
And this recognizes the need to support them so they don't get to that stage.
Right.
Yeah, when you hear something like that, Mayor, you served alongside so many men and women, brave men and women in our country. When you hear a statistic like that, it's got to break your heart.
It does. I mean, it tears me up inside, you know, to think about that. And what we can do as a community, mm-hmm. you know, to give back and say, hey, help. Can we help with that depression somehow? Mm-hmm. Can we get you together with other people and bring you from a depression point back to, you know, being fully functional and getting back involved in the community? And we think that that's really key to what we can do, both from a political standpoint and as a community at large,
right.
to help that situation.
And that's a focus of the American Legion, to find any kind of connection that helps them better prepare for life back in the community.
Sure.
So whether it's getting them to the Veterans Administration Hospital, whether it's giving them some kind of psychological treatment, they come back with many needs, and they don't also understand the benefits available to them. So that's the part the American Legion plays.
Wow.
And the city then, with this Veterans Day, Parks and Recreation runs it, but we're equal partner. Mm-hmm. So a lot of activities do go together to make this work, and it really
so
is a great
cool.
program.
I love this event. So the silent auction and the only fireworks.
Huge fireworks. The biggest.
That's it. Thank you guys for being here, and thank you for being here for 5 Talk Street. We'll see you next time.